Hi everyone, welcome to FA channel. You're in a space where we learn, explore, and experience every magic of art, technology, and creativity. So lately I've been practicing this new software called CLO3d. For those of you who've watched our video, you may have seen the one that I made one piece of fabric clothes, like very simple one on my avatar. If you're interested, please click on this video. It's a simple video to show you how I wear that piece of clothes on my avatar. And because that was like the first couple of days I learned that software, so the clothes is very simple. As I watched more tutorials, I wanted to make another piece for my partner's avatar. This is what the video is about. I want to show you guys what kind of tricks I've learned when I make this piece of puffer jacket for him. Because to me, learning from other people is important. Most of the clothes tutorials out there are very detail oriented because CLO3d is originally made for digital fashion and prototype for fashion piece. But for us, learning CLO is like a really fun experiment in terms of wearing for the avatar. So I skipped a lot of complicated parts, and I want to show you how you get creative with the software, make something as crazy as you want, and then how to wear it on your avatar with Blender. So as you can see, the first trick I've learned to make a puffer jacket, you don't have to create a pattern from scratch, because in CLO3d, they have existing t-shirt patterns. So you just need to start with, let your avatar wear the t-shirt and stretch the length, make a puffer jacket just based on this t-shirt. Is way easier and you can get more creative with it, and you can change the shape and make the clothes whatever you like, really. Like, there's no specific rule about it. Of course, I will put the link of this original tutorials I learned. Of course, I skipped a lot of details. For example, folding of the sleeves, it actually looks pretty good when you import into Blender. Later on, I will explain more, because when you are using Blender to make clothes for your avatar, there are a lot of unnecessary things that you need to delete to make it less heavy when you go into the VR chat. So this video is specifically make avatars for VR chat, the 3D avatars to go to the VR world. So there are a lot of details you really don't need. Of course, with the CLO, you need to figure out how to make certain patterns and how to sew the pattern to make clothes. And you can start, I really suggest start with this puffer jacket tutorial, and you can really be creative about it, because for example, instead of making pockets and quilt as the tutorial do, I just make two zipper pockets on the top of the shoulder, which is kind of rare on a normal clothes, and I tested different fabrics that CLO have for you for free for the front part, the pattern, and the back. I use completely different fabric, and with the front one I use kind of leather, like it actually looks really good on the avatar. So you can just really play around with a different material. It doesn't have to be too complicated at the beginning, but you can really enjoy the process, because to me, to see the result in a short of time, for me it's very important. I don't really have a lot of time to learn all the details at this point. In the future, we will continue try to make more complicated, newer version of the clothes. I want to be more creative on making avatar clothes in CLO, and I will keep you guys updated with new videos for sure. And the third trick I've learned is, if you want to make a puffer jacket, make it like the material looks puffed, the simple trick is to make two layers of your clothes. Then one layer, you can go to the pressure part and make it positive 1 to 10, and the number is really depends on what kind of effect you want to give for your clothes. And then the another group of all the fabrics, you can make it negative the same number with a positive. For example, if the first layer is positive 1, and then the underneath layer is negative one. So I just play around and see what kind of effect I like, what kind of clothes at the end is like what I want, is I want avatar to wear. So that's another trick I learned. It's really fun. You can just simply make some kind of fabric on your body and then make it as crazy as possible. Whenever I'm learning a new software, I don't really go too complicated at the beginning, because then I lose interest of learning. Try to be creative, experiment with the software, and then try to make something simple at the beginning. As time goes by and your skill gets better, then try it out and experiment on it. I'm sure you eventually will make something you really love. You don't necessarily need to be super techy to make a clothes with the clothes software. That's what I'm thinking. In terms of how to wear it, it's a bit tricky. You need to know, of course, for people who doesn't know Blender, it's a bit hard, but I will give you a step-by-step how we wear this clothes for the avatar. It's not super detailed. If you have specific questions, please don't hesitate to ask us or join our Discord group. We'd love to help figure out how you wear it. But the basic step is, first of all, you need to set up your avatar for Unity use. And the second one is import clothes in Blender and then adjust the position. And at this point, you can delete the original avatar that come with CLO, and then push proportional editing to make it look natural. For example, this avatar really like, I just made the top. The pants is still the same, so you need to adjust with the proportional editing, and just try it and see how it looked like. You really want to make sure it looks natural on this avatar as you move around. It's not going to look awkward. So now you need to delete old and seam mesh. To be able to do that, you need to keep the surface of the clothes. As I mentioned, with CLO, there are so much details you can do on the software. So there are a lot of unnecessary details underneath. Like for example, if I want a puffer, I have another layer of clothes. You need to delete all those to keep the surface. How you can see the surface is to use the editing mode and press L. Then when you press L, the only surface will show, just like this. And then when you combine all the mesh later, you need the identical UV maps. Once you create a UV map, you need to export a UV layout. Then open the file with Photoshop and then lay out the image, come with a flow like this. then export to Photoshop, put it back to Blender. Now then, you just rename the UV maps to identical. And join them and merge vertices manually. If you merge automatically, sometimes it goes the wrong way. And then if UV maps don't have the identical name, then the map will just disappear. When the mesh joins, I don't know why, but it happens like that. So you need to the UV map does have to have the identical name. Now you just parent close mesh to the bone with automatic weight. Then you check with the pose mode and adjust weight paint if needed. At this point, if you really messed up, don't worry, just unparent them and parent again with automatic weight. The last step will be export as FBX file with CATS plugin. Now here you have it. Check out our new clothes on the avatar, and it looks pretty good. The process takes a bit long. With making the clothes, I think it takes me a couple hours, not too long, but with wearing the clothes, it takes a bit longer. Depends on how complicated your clothes is. Like for example, I bought my clothes, the clothes I'm wearing right now. I bought this in the virtual market 5. I also talk about how I wear this on my avatar. It's a bit tricky for sure. That's why I want you, don't be afraid to experiment, try out. And if you have any questions, please let us know. I just find it really exciting to try new things, and what is more fun, to continue making your new clothes for your avatar. You can sometime buy it, sometime make it. I wish one day I can make more fun, complicated clothes in the future for both of our avatars, and perhaps in the future I can even sell it for fun. So yeah, that's it for today's video. I hope you enjoy it. I hope you something that you learn from our videos. Please subscribe our channel for new upcoming videos in the future. Thank you so much for watching. Please don't hesitate to ask any questions. We're here to help. We're here to explore and celebrate together. And that's it for today's video. I will see you next time. Take care. Bye.